We've currently been delivering training to teachers in Northern Ireland, but also in the border counties as well. And this has meant that there is a real cross-community, cross-border feel to the project, which is what we wanted to get out of the project, and that will make it more beneficial in the long term.
Well, we do have a very secure link with St Mary's and St Cecilia's, and we are very aware of the work that they're doing with the Digital Histories project as well. And so it has given us another opportunity to do cross-community work with them. And hopefully the new Digital Histories project will help us to keep developing that.
It's hard to explain the difference that it makes when you bring different communities together to look at the issues, these big issues that affect all of us. And we've seen it in our junior school, and we've also seen it in the Teaching Divided Histories project. The task or the challenge that you face when you start to look at sectarian issues and hate crime and so on, when you look at these issues with a mixed class from different communities and different traditions, that the way in which you tackle those issues and the way in which the pupils engage with those issues is very, very different. And therefore, their level of engagement increases, their empathy and understanding increases, and their listening skills increase, because suddenly they will hear for themselves the lived realities of people who come from a different tradition than themselves. So I think this is one of the key aspects of the programme that has made it so successful.
I think it's important that the students have this opportunity to learn about the conflict in Northern Ireland, because it helps them really to understand their own identity and culture much more, and also to respect that of others. It helps to dispel stereotypes and bias when they're actually learning the facts of what has happened. I have found throughout the project that actually the students have been kind of more appreciative of the other perspective. And I was particularly struck when they were participating in the lesson on the Protestant exodus from Derry, that they were actually very compassionate towards the exodus that took place. It was opening up their opportunities and their understanding of history much more.
It's important to learn about the history of the Troubles in school, so we're taught the right events and we're not influenced by our communities to what side to choose. Doing divided history has taught us not to be biased and just to think about it from two points of view.
I think it's good they work with all our schools, because then you learn their different points of view and what they think on the topic.
The Teaching Divided History project has given schools and teachers the opportunity to become involved at a cross-community level and cross-border level. And it's always excellent to take those opportunities when they arise, because it helps kind of widen ideas and share experiences.
So although it may appear at first sight that the resource is more designed for use within the Northern Ireland curriculum, I think there are very clear links between the resources and the Southern Irish curriculum, whether it be in transition year or in leaving certificate history for teachers who take the special option on Northern Ireland. So in that sense, it can be seen very genuinely as a cross-border resource.
For us, working with the schools in the north has been great, because first of all, we would never have done that prior to the Divided Histories project. We would never have thought to even look into Derry and to see what was there. But the way that they teach history in the north is completely different from the way we teach it here in the south. And we probably have stepped up now and started to use more digital images, more video, all of that sort of stuff within our classrooms. Well, as a teacher of Leaving Cert history as well, I find the project has introduced me to a huge amount of resources that are out there and that are available. I can also use some of the comic strips that the transition year students have used to introduce the whole topic of civil rights to fourth and fifth year Leaving Cert students, and they find this very humorous, and it actually brings, you know, introduces the topic great to them.
I found using comic life within the lesson much more entertaining and engaging than I have any other lesson up to transition year, and including the Leaving Cert that I've done so far. You know, it's the Leaving Cert and Junior Cert are all very textbook orientated. I think it's kind of old fashioned and they should move on. I think this comic life was a breath of new life, using media and then the television, internet and even newspaper clippings and things to help you be educated.
I find using comic life really interesting, as it gave the students an opportunity to source information for themselves rather than depending on the teachers, which made it more memorable.
Without doubt, I think it's very important that we learn about the conflict, because I think to move forward, the two communities, especially the Unionists and Nationalists, to move forward, I think it's important that you know all the facts about the past.
I found using comic life in the class far easier than using textbooks, because it's creative and you can just go as you're going along. You don't have to follow a set of, you know, instructions along reading stuff, just make it up as you go.
The Divided Histories project has really brought to light to us the amount of resources and sources that are on our doorstep. We now are using Derry more for taking the children in to do the tour of Derry, the walls of Derry, and further afield to Stormont. Like, we had the opportunity to go to Stormont through the project. None of our children had ever been to Stormont. Some of them had never been to Belfast. For us, it was a great opportunity. They had a fantastic day. More recently as well, we're getting involved more in the tour of Derry and the walls of Derry, going into the Tower Museum and all of that sort of stuff. And for a lot of the students, they see it every day doing shopping, but they never actually see what's there.
I think it's very important that the students get the opportunity to learn about the Troubles, both the side of the border and the other side. Sometimes the course content can brush over it very, very scantily, and they don't go into it in depth. And it's something that we're very close to the border here, and a lot of our students would either be from Derry, or their parents are from Derry, or they have connection, and it touches a nerve with them, and they gain an interest straight away. And if you can apply this then with something, whether it's digital media, it's way more interesting straight away.
The students really enjoyed the project. They find it completely different from anything that they'd ever studied in junior cert history. And because it's not compulsory here for transition year students in the school, they now get to study history completely differently.